Hey everybody, this is Allie Craig for the Neurohuman Branding Academy. On this week's episode of 7 Seconds, we're talking about how in the world to use your stories to create connections during a 7 second window. Now, if you're unaware of what 7 seconds is about, well, basically you have 7 seconds from the time a subconscious idea thought rises to the top of the surface of your brain or your audience's brain. You have 7 seconds from the time it comes up to the time it's going to go over to the conscious side of life. Meaning that when it hits that conscious side of life, it's the need, it's the want, it's the pain at that point. So basically, you realize, oh my gosh, I need to find a florist. You have 7 seconds to be in that window of your audience's mind for them to instinctually think of you as their go-to florist before we get to the pain side and they start doing crazy things like Googling. They need to think of you in that window. And using your social stories is a great way to create the connection and fill that 7 second, be the answer before the problem even really arises. How do you do that? Social stories are, well, the perfect way that we all learn nowadays. Human beings learn, mimic by what we see. That's how we understand how to behave. That's how we understand what to expect in a new situation. It's what we've seen throughout TV, movies, books, and stories we've been told. And I'm pretty sure there's a social story out there, be it a TV, movie, or a book that, well, relates to your industry, relates to the pain that your audience feels, or the expectation your audience has. So guess what? When you just reference it in simple ways, then your audience can relate to it. And therefore, when the need arises, they're going to more likely remember you and your brand because you've attached your brand to a memory, aka a social story they've already had. Want to know what that looks like when it actually comes to your brand? I'm going to share with you one that I use well, relatively often because, well, the audiences I'm reaching are the Xers and Yers. So that means kids born in the 80s and 90s. What were the most influential movies of the time? Well, When Harry Met Sally was still a big buzz. So what is that iconic scene in When Harry Met Sally? When Sally and Harry are in that delicatessen and Sally's trying to show Harry that, yeah, ladies can fake it, if you know what I mean. Well, that moment where she's just going, yes, on camera, guess what? That's something, that memory, most people can relate to. So when you're trying to show enthusiasm, excitement, overwhelming joy, if you write copy around the fact of, you know, and if this is, if you're like Sally in that famous delicatessen scene in the movie When Harry Met Sally at this moment, then guess what? This product is the right product for you. People know what that means. So when they're thinking about your product or service and they have that need, you're most likely going to be top of mind, literally, because you've attached your brand to a memory that they've already had, as well as the social story at play, making you more iconic, memorable, and most importantly, fulfilling a need that your audience has before it ever gets to that pain point in life. So that way they think of the need and they think of you. Perfect relationship, right?